Hi everyone, I'm Shelly from There's No Place Like Home at redheadmom8.wordpress.com. I know that I have not uploaded a video in a while, and I am sorry. The stomach virus has been blazing its way through our house, and so we are finally at the point where no one is sick anymore. Two of my kids still have not gotten it at all, so let's just pray that they don't. So anyway, I decided today that I'm going to talk about something that most homeschoolers are likely to have to deal with at some point in their homeschool career, and that is this one thing, the homeschool hater. If you have been homeschooling for any length of time, chances are that you've realized by now that there are going to be people in your life or people that you might not know personally, but who you come across that have a very different opinion on homeschooling than you do. And you know, that is to be expected. We live in a world where there is not a single topic that everyone agrees on. You might find something that you think is completely cut and dry, that no one would ever disagree with you on, only to find that, yeah, there is a whole other group who has a differing opinion on what you believe about a certain thing. So truly, why should homeschooling be any different? And that's okay. I'm sure that there are a lot of things that other people think that you don't agree with either. But you know, it can be really hard as a homeschooler to deal with the homeschool haters. And you know, there are really two groups of people that I have come across that tend to have differing opinions about homeschooling. The first group I wouldn't necessarily call haters. I would call them concerned but misinformed. Very typically, they are friends and family members, people who know you personally and who are simply concerned about your children and don't understand what homeschooling is all about. And you know, sometimes it can be easier to deal with this sort of person than a homeschool hater, especially if they are a person that you truly do believe is open to learning what homeschooling is all about but just doesn't understand it quite yet. So if you think that you have someone in your life in this category, you know, you could definitely try to include them in your children's homeschooling routine. Maybe ask them over to do an art class sometime, or have them go along with you on a field trip. Show them pictures of your kids doing their activities. Share the curriculum that you're using, or just have a visit with your kids with them so that they can see, you know, how your kids are developing, not only academically, but socially, you know, those social skills that so many homeschoolers are supposed to not have. But here's something really, really important that I want to say as I'm telling you that you can share your life with these people, is that in all honesty, you do not owe these people anything. Even if they are your family member, even if they are your friends, don't ever feel like because they are thinking one way that you must be doing something wrong. Yes, you can definitely include them in all these areas of homeschooling just to help them to understand a little bit better. But if it doesn't work, you are by no means obligated to keep trying to prove yourself to them. And that is really, really important. You are the parent of your child. No one else is. Now, another thing that I want to add that you could possibly do for people who you think are just misinformed is, you know, if they like to read, send them articles, send them posts, send them books, especially John Taylor Gatto books on the history of compulsory schooling. That's what really opened up my eyes. But yeah, you can definitely try to do things to help your acquaintances or your friends or your family members to get a better grip on what homeschooling actually is. But unfortunately, it doesn't always mean that it's going to work. And this is where I'm going to get into the second group, the outright homeschool haters. These are people that no matter what you do or say or show to them, they will never change their opinion on homeschooling. You could share statistics with them. You could have your kids visit with them and show them how lovely your kids are turning out to be. You could show them your kids' projects. You could invite them over. And it doesn't matter what you do. They are going to always just walk the straight and narrow and think that school is the only way, and that if you are doing something any different than that, you are definitely doing something that is going to be detrimental to your children's future. Now, fortunately, it's usually very easy to tell right from the outset if somebody is going to have this sort of attitude when they bring up homeschooling with you. You can kind of tell in their mannerisms and the way that they say things. So, you know, when I was talking about the other group of people who you think might be open to homeschooling, yes, definitely gauge who you're going to really try to spend time talking to them about homeschooling is about. But if you really have any sort of inkling that you're talking to someone who might fall into this group of being a homeschool hater, honestly, I'm going to tell you, don't worry about wasting your time on them. And sometimes, these might be people who are just suspicious of anything not mainstream, and they will get downright angry if you deviate in any sort of way from the narrative. They might be people who have a career in education or who have a family history in education. And what I have to tell you is that this, by all means, does not mean that it is all teachers who feel this way. Definitely not, because teachers are coming out of the woodwork in support of homeschooling because they see what is going on in the schools. So I don't ever want people to think that, teachers are always going to be against homeschooling. That is absolutely not the way. And the funny part about it is that what I have found is that it seems like the older generation of teachers lately have been the ones that are in more support of homeschooling, and it is the newest generation, those freshly out of college, those very often are the ones who really seem to have difficulty accepting it. And I think it's really a difference in the way that they are being educated and the way they're being trained in preparation for this job. And so the last group of people that might become homeschool haters are just those that believe that big government is the only way, and that they think that individuals couldn't possibly get anything right without the government, kind of like leading them along on a leash. So it makes them uncomfortable to the point that they will bash anything that goes against that lifestyle. And here's the thing. Unfortunately, even though most homeschool haters, you will meet online. That is a guarantee. That's where most of the homeschool haters will come from, because people who are hiding behind a screen are not afraid to say what they really think. Whereas people who you meet in person might have a better filter on them than those that you meet online. So if you meet someone online, that's one thing. You don't even have to worry about that. Unfortunately, there you might come across somebody who is a homeschool hater and isn't afraid to hide it. And this is someone that you either know personally, or at least is an acquaintance, or someone that you might just come across in the store. And here's the thing. Some nice techniques that you can use are to just change the subject. You might tell them that your decision is not up for discussion. Or, unfortunately, there are times where you might simply have to just walk away. And this is where, and this is, I'm going to mention it again, it is so important to gauge how you think that these people are feeling beneath, because that can make all the difference in so many things. There are people, I think, who are misinformed about homeschooling, and that if you would only share things with them about homeschooling, who knows, one day they might decide to start homeschooling their own children. But there really are people who are outright cynical, and you can usually tell these people by the sneer on their face when you bring up homeschooling. So if changing the subject doesn't work with them, and if telling them that it's not up for discussion doesn't work with them, you are going to have to come to a point where you realize that you just need to ignore them. And here's the thing, it is neither their business nor their choice for how your children are educated. And this is important to remember when you are speaking to anyone who differs in their homeschooling opinion, is that you do not owe an explanation to anyone. And I understand that this can be hard sometimes. It can be hard to live with family who has a differing opinion, especially on something as major as homeschooling, or as major as education in general. But the thing is that if you have tried everything that you could do, or if you have just, if you've understood that they are going to be completely malicious against homeschooling, and you have just tried to politely change the subject, and things just aren't working, I'm giving you permission to today. Ignore them. No one owes, you don't owe an explanation to anyone. You and your husband, or you and your wife, whoever is watching this video, it is your decision and your decision alone, and not anyone else's. Anyway, that's all that I have for you today. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed yet and would like to hear more of what I have to say, I would love if you would do that. If you have any questions or comments, you can leave one over on Instagram, because YouTube disabled my comments. And if you like my work and would like to check out my Patreon page, I will leave a link in the description box for that as well. And I hope you have a great day.